Hi, welcome back to my channel. In the previous video, we discussed what is UX writing and microcopy, and also discussed three of my favorite tips for writing microcopy. Let's recap. The first tip that I like is that make your microcopy clear to the users, which means replace technical jargon with words that the user is familiar with and rephrase the message so that it makes sense from the user's perspective and not from the system or the developer's perspective. My second favorite tip is that make sure that every word on the UI has a distinct purpose. And my final favorite tip is that make sure that the user has all the information they need to make informed decisions and also understand the consequences of those decisions. In today's video, I want to talk about my favorite online platform, which does an amazing job at user experience and microcopy. And that platform is DigitalOcean. DigitalOcean is a cloud infrastructure provider that helps you deploy and scale apps in the cloud. So let's look at DigitalOcean's user interface, and I'll walk you through some of my favorite elements of the user experience and microcopy. Okay, so this is DigitalOcean's welcome screen. One of my favorite parts about their user experience is the onboarding process. So to walk you through their onboarding process, I created a brand new account and I already confirmed my email and entered my card details. And this is my favorite part of the onboarding process, the project goals. So as a new user, I don't know what I can use DigitalOcean for. So they are helping me make the choices and giving me all the options that I need to consider. And I just love this process. And they also have a very conversational language, which works very well with their brand. Like from my perspective, the DigitalOcean brand is all about ease and accessibility and welcoming and conversational. So I think their tone matches their brand very well. So let's go through the user experience. So it says, welcome. To begin, let's create a new project. So the tone of the language is very conversational and friendly. Like, we are in this together. We are going to build this together. It's not like, okay, you do this. It's not directing or ordering the user to do something. It's a very approachable language, explaining and educating the user on what the product is. Note, you can change the name, redefine the purpose, and move resources between projects as you need. This is a brilliant piece of microcopy because this is preemptively answering the questions that the user might have. This little line here shows how carefully they have thought through the user experience. Like, they have really thought through what is the frame of mind of the user, and they have tried to understand what are the questions that the user might have and then preemptively answer them. I think this is a brilliant move because it builds trust as a user in the product, that the company who creates this product is really thinking about me right now. Okay, so it's telling me that I can change the name and redefine the purpose and move resources later. So I can go ahead and make the choice, and if I make the wrong choice, that will be fine because I'll be able to change it later. So let's do that. Project name, trial. Okay, what is your project for? This information will help us improve the project's experience based on what you're building. Okay, just trying out DigitalOcean. Tell us which tools or technologies you plan to use on DigitalOcean. Okay, I probably will use Kubernetes and Docker. Deployment, I don't need a deployment. Development tools, I'll probably use GitHub. And where's Python. Okay, and probably Postgres. I don't need monitoring. I don't need other cloud providers. And I don't need to publish. So that's all I need. And for now, it's just me. And then start. Do you see how easy and guided this process was? Like, it really made me think about what I want to do on this platform and what technologies I'll use and what I'll use them for. So this is helping the user understand what all you can do with the platform and then helping them make the right choice. Trial. This is your first project. Create new projects and organize your resources to suit your workflow. Okay. Create droplet. Okay, so let's create a new droplet. DigitalOcean droplets are flexible Linux based that run on top of virtualized hardware. Each droplet you create is a new server you can use. So what they're doing here is helping the user understand the term droplet, because it's a new term. It's not a term that is prevalent in software engineering. That is a new term that DigitalOcean developed themselves. So since it's introducing new terminology, they're also giving their definition and the use of that term and what that would mean. So I love this piece of Microcopy. So helpful. Okay, let's create a droplet. Okay, now once we are creating a droplet, they're again going to walk me through the process of what droplet I want. For now, I'm just going to use Ubuntu. It's fine. And I'm going to use the smallest one. I don't need storage. I should probably want it closer to me. I don't want any of the additional options. I don't want to add an SSH key. And each of them have these little tooltips. These are tooltips to help the user understand what decisions they are supposed to make here. Like, what does choosing an image mean? And once they understand what an image means, then they can go and make the right decision. For example, this tooltip tells me that adding an SSH key is recommended security measure. If you choose not to add one, you will receive a root password via email. So from a user's perspective, they're telling me what I can do and choose not to do and what will happen in either case. Like, if I want, I can add my own SSH key, and if I don't, then they will generate a root password for me and send it to me. So it's helping the user make informed decisions. Another thing, I wanted to show you an empty state. Let's go to a new project. No, that's not what I want. Match. Let's go to the databases page because I want to show you this. So this is what is called an empty state. Like, I have not created a database yet. So they could have just had a blank page here with this button called create a database cluster. But instead, they take this opportunity to inform and educate the user about the possible databases. So they tell me about the managed databases, and they tell me what that means is that DigitalOcean will manage my database, so I don't have to. Then they also tell me about why I should choose that these are the features, and then they point me to resources where I can learn more about it. So this is an excellent use of what is called an empty state, which is there are no databases in my project right now. So instead of just telling me that I can create one, they tell me what that means and why I should do it and how to do it. So this is one of my favorite examples of empty states. Now if we create a new project, try it too, and again just trying it out. For now, this is another empty state. So this is what a typical empty state looks like, but because I already have a droplet, they don't need to educate me again about what a droplet means. So they just have like a basic empty state, which is just literally a blank page with the getting started button. So that's what I wanted to show you, like a full-blown empty state with all the resources and information, and then a standard empty state. Okay, now let's try deleting a project, and look at this line of Microcopy. To delete a project, you must move or delete all resources within it. Again, guiding the user about how to do a particular task. If we delete it, this is what is called a confirmation message. So this is a pretty standard confirmation message. I'm going to do that. And this is what is called a success message. It's telling me that the task that I was trying to accomplish was accomplished successfully. So these are the main types of messages that you need to write Microcopy for: success messages, error messages, and confirmation messages. Okay, let me go and try to create a database cluster. Again, this is another onboarding for a different part of the product. So we already had the onboarding for DigitalOcean, then we had an onboarding for a droplet creation, and now we have an onboarding for a database cluster. So it's a very thought out user journey, and they have optimized the onboarding process for each part of the product. Again, they walk me through all the decision making, and they also tell me what I can and cannot do and the consequences of making those decisions. Data center. Again, they have a very helpful tip here about which data center in the world should I choose. And this is critically important because choosing the right data center is important for good application performance. So that's what they mean here, is that if I choose a data center that is farther from me, then it will add latency and it will result in slow performance. So this is again preemptively understanding what the user might face once they build the application and helping them make the choice right now. So you see why I love this UI so much. It's like they have thought through the user experience and they know their users so intricately and so well, and it's a completely user-focused workflow, and they use Microcopy beautifully to help the user accomplish what they need to accomplish. That's why I love DigitalOcean so much. I hope this video was helpful. If you would like to watch more tech writing videos, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be notified when the new video is up. I'll see you next time. Until then, happy writing!